Hello!
Welcome.
Prevent.
How are we doing?
I was in Oakland on Saturday, visiting a beer festival, a brewery pub, and booths.
Yeah.
While I was in booths, Andrew picked up this, for the reason being...
We have a local band called Route 66, so I went, yes, I'm going to get that.
Yeah, so if you're in Yorkshire... especially in Route 66 Yorkshire Band or something like that. I'm sure they'll have tracks and stuff like that on the internet. It's from Eden Brewery out of Cumbria. It's a cool fermented Pilsner. And I'm just looking at that there. Look, really cool.
Is it like a main?
Yeah. It's like an evil monkey. Bottle opener.
First quenching real ales from.
Who's coming back?
Brewed all.
Yeah, I've put a load of links. I mean, there's loads of stuff about this brewery. But I'm assuming because it says Cumbria, there's other Eden breweries. I think there's one in Devon. I'm not sure. Wow. Very aromatic. Is it a green bottle? It's slightly skunky. I can smell it from here.
Mm.
Where's the links?
It does come off like that sort of chick style beer, doesn't it?
Yeah, one of the links has a with nail and eye inspires Cumbrian brewer.
Penrith. Get your kicks. On Route 66, okay, so 66 Pilsner, is it named after the iconic American highway? But our very own A66, which is partly follows the route of the original Roman road from Scotch Corner through the Eden Valley to Penrith, taking some spectacular scenery along the way. In the 1970s, the A66 was extended towards Cumbria, West Coast, trespassing into road number zone 5. Our Pilsner Lager is a traditional brewed using Saaz hops from refreshing continental flavours. It's a cold fermented and extended period before conditioning with additional hops.
Now, I'm just looking on this. Sandra mentioned a song. What the song was, was it by Nat King Cole? I'm sure it was like a rock ballad, wasn't it?
Because the band of Route 66 that plays at our local pub, they actually have a song that sort of mingles the Route 66 sort of tune, you know what I mean? Because they sing blues. American blues.
Yeah. Well, so maybe it actually might be Nat King Cole. It's a green bottle.
Mm.
Slight caramel aftertaste.
Quite funky though.
But it has got a lot of the European feel to it.
Mm.
Like some of the European Czech beers that we drink.
That's a right funny aftertaste. I'm sort of losing my mouth. It's kind of dry as well.
The slight apple aroma.
Mm.
It's not bad. It's quite. Honestly, I can't remember how much you pay for it at booths in Ilkley.
A couple of quid.
So yeah. Like, so it's not bad.
Not too bad.
You're getting a beer that's dedicated to either a theme or something like that.
Well, it's dedicated to many things, really. It's sort of Route 66, emblazoning the American highway. Not only that, it was sort of like collaborated with the A66, which is the English version, so to speak, which is what goes across England.
Yeah, I mean, it starts off really skunky, but it does get a little bit easier drinking. It's not bad. I would buy it again.
Mm.
It's a nice beer. I can't fault it. It's a nice session beer.
I mean, we've got it at room temperature at the moment. It's okay, it's not too bad.
It's still slightly chilled. It's only been at room temperature for about half an hour.
I mean...
So we'll try to find some information about the actual brewery, won't we, and history. But, yeah, I mean, I've put the links down below. So check out the links.
Put it down below.
Yeah. check out the links, because we've been reading some of it, and it was quite interesting, some of it. I mean, they got started brewing about 2012, so they are pretty new-ish.
Didn't Aidan Brewery used to have some in Morrison's at one time?
They might have done. I'll just give a little shake, because you didn't think that. Just see if we can get more flavours from the beer. It's, I don't think it will be out of date, because spoofs are pretty on form with the dates, but a lot of breweries don't actually list the dates because they don't believe in putting dates on bottles.
Well, it's a little bit more flavour there. And smoother.
It's a little bit better. You're getting a little bit of cork, maybe aroma, like you know, you get like a little stuffy cork in the bottle. But it's a nice beer. Would I recommend it? Yeah. For anybody that drinks lagers, yeah. For anybody that balances the two between ales and lagers, it's a tasty beer. Check out proofs. Check out this beer. You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.